Hello friends, today's topic that we are discussing is rural livelihood, that means living style in the village areas. While we are thinking about a village, we will be having many different type of images in our mind, where calm and quiet atmosphere, many different types of animals, birds, etc. are freely moving here and there, very less population, and all of them are keeping a warm relation with each and everyone. Such a good area where good climatic condition, that is atmospheric condition, where fresh air, fresh water, good relation among them, etc. is simply come to our mind whenever we are talking about villages. So, what are the most important jobs or occupations that people are doing in village, and whatever methods are there for them to meet their daily needs, etc. need to discuss in this lesson. As we discussed about many type of diversities are existing in our country, village also is a good example, mainly to find out such a different or diverse jobs or lifestyle here. Commonly in a village area, majority people will be having agriculture or farming as their major occupation. Some other group of people will be having owners of different shops. Some others may be having different services, just like blacksmiths, goldsmith, washermen, weavers, barbers, nurses, etc. And somebody will be having their different shops, like tea shop or textile shop or tailoring shop or mechanics, etc. also will be commonly found in the village areas. Even though different occupations are found in villages, majority people are considering agriculture or farming as their major important scope of getting a job. And in case of farming community also, they also are differ from one another. Why means that we can say somebody will be having a little bit acres of land in their hand. They are large land owners. Some others will be having 1 or 2 acres of land for their agricultural purpose. They are small landowners. But other than these two, that is large or small landowners, somebody will be having a group of people with no land of their own. That is landless laborers or farmers also will be there in the village areas. And these people need to depend upon the small farmers or the large farm owners in order to get a job. Agriculture is a seasonal work. Whenever the rainy season starts or monsoon season starts, major agricultural activities also starts. So, agriculture having some different seasons according to the importance of its procedure. In the beginning, the tilling soil or making the land ready for agriculture and sowing seeds, etc. will be the most important job. And after 1 or 2 months, then another job in the name of using pesticides or avoiding all the weeds or the unwanted plants, etc. will be the next session. And in the third stage, it will be harvesting. After continuous days or months of work, all the different crops will be ready for harvesting. So harvesting season is the another one. So many of the people in the villages are getting job in these 3 seasons mainly. But we know that agriculture will not provide job for people throughout an year. So other than this harvesting or sowing time, after that people in the villages, those who are depending on farming, will have to face a problem of jobless situation. So in such unemployed season, they have to either they need to borrow money from their neighbors or from their friends or any other money lenders in their locality. Or they need to find out a job in the nearby villages or in any other field, because farming is only for a particular season. After that season, people need to find out any other possible jobs. So other than agriculture or this seasonal work, many other jobs, just like shops will be there, rice mill will be there, or cattle herding will be. And these cattle herders also will be having another a situation where they can collect all the milk and can provide all that milk into milk society. So many such different jobs also will be there in a village area. Most often the villagers, especially the farmers, are getting very less wages for their hard work. Their work may be starting from 8 o'clock or in the early morning, and continuous hours of job will be there in the field or in the farm field, and they are getting very less to feed their family. So the major problem that the villagers, especially the landless farmers, are facing is that they will be in debt. That means they need to borrow money from others, and they need to face all other consequences in their daily life. Whenever the money lenders are asking the villagers or the landless farmers to repay the money that they borrowed, many different type of problems will be there, mainly because of the less money in their pocket, and all the other emergencies at home, etc., makes them into a difficulty situation where they are unable to pay the money back to who or from whom they collected or they borrowed it. The poor agricultural families are, especially in rural areas, are spending a lot of time every day collecting firewood, getting water, and grazing their animals along with doing their agricultural activities. Even though they do not earn many money from these activities, they have to do all these jobs for their house or for their home activities. Nearly 2/5 of all rural families in our country are agricultural laborers. There are some who have small plots of land, while others have less acres of land, or somebody will be landless. The major difference between the large landowners or agricultural laborers and small farmers in India are that large farm owners are utilizing majority of their agricultural land for cultivating any varieties of crops, and they also are able to sell these extra or surplus product in the nearby markets, maybe in their own village or in the nearby town. So they are able to get the profit out of their selling, and this money can be used by them for the next years of crops or seeds or all other extra other activities, just like tractor need to be facilitated, irrigation facility, etc. But in case of small farmers, maybe they have 2 or 3 acres of land, and they are unable to hire any laborer into their family or into their farm. All the members of that family is doing that agricultural job by their own, and all what they are producing in their farmland may be for their own consumption alone. They haven't any more extra or surplus production to sell in the nearby market. So after their consumption, there will be no any extra seeds for the next year. So whenever the agricultural activity starts in the next year, again these small farmers need to depend on the large farmers to get seeds, then fertilizers, etc., or need to get money from them to buy all these materials for agricultural purpose. So a great gap is there in between small farmers and large farmers. The condition of the landless farmers are really pity, because they haven't any land of their own, and their job also is not continuous for an year. So they have to be in a pitiable condition, that is where whenever they need a little bit more money, they need to borrow it from others. So throughout their life, they will be a borrower and also will be debt trapped. The people, those who are living in the coastal areas or near to oceans or seas also, are not much better than a farmer, because people, those who are in the coastal areas, are doing fishing as their job, and this fishing also have a particular season where they are allowed to go to sea or to water to fetch the fish, and in some other seasons the government will not allow them to fetch fish from the oceans. And many kind of maintenances also may be needed for their boat. Many of the fishers will be having their own boat or catamaran, and so may be having a net and all other equipments. So they do not want to borrow money for any such items. But in case if fishers having no any boat or catamaran of their own, they need to get it as for using from anybody else, and need to pay its rent also. So in case if they have any kind of dangers, just like storm or any other situations in the sea, their life also will be in danger. And all the fish that they are collecting also will be sold in the market with auction. So a little bit higher prices will be given or will be get for them in order to feed their family. And that also sometimes may be not sufficient for the family needs. So most commonly in the rural areas where people having no any regular job, no permanent job, mostly their life condition will be in danger. Many different situations will be there in their life to face, especially emergencies also, but they haven't any money in their own pocket. So most commonly they are depending on the money lenders nearby or any such great or richest persons nearby, and they need to borrow money from them and need to repay that money whenever they are demanding. But in case of poor farmers or these type of fishermen in this locality, even though they haven't any much money for their own need itself, then it will be very difficult for them to refund the money that they borrowed from the others. So a real situation where many kinds of problems are there in the rural areas where people haven't any continuous job. Survival in these areas are very much difficulty, especially for those who are depending on land or on the oceans. So this chapter gave a little bit of details about the diverse occupations that is found in the village areas and the difficulties that different group of people are facing regularly, mainly because of their less job opportunities, mainly because of their less education, and also the difficulties especially on the form of lack of money. So it may be so common everywhere throughout the world, not only in our country. The same condition may be there for landless workers or fishermen or craft persons, etc., throughout the world. So this chapter gave details about the different jobs and the livelihood or the lifestyle of people in village areas. So let us stop now. Thank you. Have a nice day.